Here, this is the textbook page of your chapter, Experiments with Water. We have gone through the actual experiments and now I am sharing a story. There also you can go through the experiments. Some extra things are also shown in this story, children. So, in our continuing videos, I will be taking this story, small portion of the story, so that your concept gets more cleared. Here we have studied about what floats, what sinks. Here we have gone through that how the puris float in the oil. First the puri sank to the bottom of the pan, then it is puffed up. This is also shown in the story which I shared with you today. And when Ayesha put a puffed puri in a bowl of water, then what happened? That also you just saw. If a steel plate is put on water, what will happen? If the cap of a plastic bottle sink or float on water, then what happens? Something float on water while others sink. The soap case floats, the soap sinks. But the soap put on the soap case, when it is kept on the soap case, then it floats. So that also you have seen. Here is a poem, very nice poem. Try to recite the poem, the various ways you can recite, and you can share that video with me also. Okay, so I'm waiting for your videos. This also, read this activity. Hope now you have filled this table as I have given this to you earlier. But I asked you to do the experiments, make a video of it and then share it with me. These fill in the blanks also now you can write, and in the textbook you please write it with the pencil. No one will use the pen to fill in the blanks. Then, is it magic? Okay, this we have seen the earlier video which I had shown you for the experiments which was performed in the beaker full of water. But in this story, we have not gone through this place. The earlier float and sink we have seen in this story. So today, just go through that story again. Read till this page and try to write down the answers. Share your videos with me. Whatever experiments you are performing at home, you can share your small 1 minute video with me. Okay, videos should be of 1 to 2 minutes only, not more than that. So in this chapter today, what we have learnt about, we will discuss once again. Facts about the water, sources of water, uses of water, flotation and buoyancy, states of matter. Flotation and buoyancy means what floats, what sink. Now, water is the basic need of all living beings. Almost 70% of our earth's surface is covered with water. Its chemical formula is H2O. Because of water, earth is also called a blue planet. Why? Because 70% of the earth is covered with the water only. What are the natural sources of water? Fresh water sources are river, lake, waterfall, well, pond, glacier, ice caps. Salty water sources are sea, ocean, salty lake. You can see the picture. यूजेज ऑफ वाटर, डोमेस्टिक यूजेज, ड्रिंकिंग, कुकिंग, क्लीनिंग, वॉशिंग, बेदिंग, कूलिंग, दैट इज़ वाटर कूलर्स, इरीगेशन. कमर्शियल यूजेज आर प्रिपरेशन ऑफ पैकेज्ड फूड आइटम्स, डाइंग, क्लीनिंग, वॉशिंग, कूलिंग एट्सेट्रा इन फैक्ट्रीज. एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट, दो इट इज़ रिटन ओवर हियर इन द एंड, वाटर ट्रांसपोर्ट. बट वी नो 70% ऑफ द अर्थ इज कवर्ड विद वाटर, 3/4 अर्थ इज वाटर एंड द शिप सेल्स ऑन द वाटर. सो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इज टेकन प्लेस बाय द वाटर ऑल्सो. Here few experiments we have already discussed. You can also do like this at your home. And you can share your videos with me. As I told you, in the story of Chinu and Minu also, lot of experiments are there. Now here is an activity work. Items required is water, bucket, ball, empty bottle, iron nail, steel plate, katori, bowl, spoon, paper boat, stone. Take a bucket having water. Now put these items one by one and tabulate your observations. Here two tables are there. What floats in water and what sinks in water. So this way you will do the experiment and then you will write your observations in this table. This is what I am asking you every time in every video. Do the activity and share your video. It is going to be very interesting activity for you all. Many experiments we did with water. Few things such as paper boat, empty bottle, katori, ball floats in water. Few things such as stone, iron nail, steel spoon sank in water. What floats in water? Light things float. What sinks in water? Heavy things sink. Here is the poem. It is in your textbook also. Make it in a different rhyming form so that you can read in various types. This poem we have gone through. Now, how does a ship sails in water? A ship when immersed in water displaces water. It is designed in such a way that the buoyant force exerted on it is more than the gravitational force which helps it to float. So here children, you know that the iron nail was sinking but the ship is floating. So here two new terms are here, buoyant force and gravitational force. Buoyant force in general term you can say that water is pushing the ship upwards. And gravitational force is, you know, gravity ka force, that it is pulled down by the earth. So when ship is there in the water, it is displacing the water. Okay, when it is going inside the water, it is displacing the water from its place. Here you can see that in this diagram, buoyant force and the gravitational force is shown with the arrow. So when this force which is pushing the ship upwards is more than the gravitational force, the ship is going to float. Okay, so it is displacing the water and that water is displaced and the water is pushing it, making it to float. You might have observed children, when you go into a bath, a tub full of water, you feel like your weight is light, you are floating. No, whenever you go in the water, what you feel like? Your legs, your body is pushed up. That is the buoyant force. Okay, when you feel like that, that liquid or water is pushing you upward and you are feeling yourself as light weighted, that is the buoyant force. So the design of the ship is made in such a way that it has more and more of a buoyant force and less of a gravitational force which is pulling it down towards the earth. That is the reason.